Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. Our friends at Educational Innovation sent us this really neat science toy called the Mystical Crystal Tree. The directions say that this amazing tree grows like magic. So I planted this tree yesterday, and today we have a tree. And we want to take a closer look at the science that makes this science toy work. We've zoomed in so we can take a closer look at what's in the kit. So let's pop it open. And I see a packet of clear solution, a little plastic tray, and two pieces of cardboard. And that's it. There's a nice simple set of directions right on the package that tells me how to put this together. So it goes like this. You'll notice some slots cut into these two cardboard pieces. This one has a slot in the top, slot in the bottom. So what happens here is they slide together so my tree can stand upright. Sometimes you have to push a little bit, and there we go. Now to make this look like a tree, I have to bend these little tree branches in all different ways. So maybe bend one forward, bend one backwards. All right, now that I have my tree branches bent, there are four little slots that allow my cardboard tree to slip into. Now, if you take a closer look at this cardboard, you're gonna notice something. Parts of the cardboard, especially the top part here, actually looks like it has a color to it. In this case, it's yellow. Now, it's because of this coloring on the cardboard that's going to make our tree become yellow when it's all grown. Now, this looks like a packet of plain, ordinary, clear water, but this is not water. There's actually something dissolved in this liquid. It's a solution. And it's that something that's dissolved in here that's going to make our tree grow. So what we have to do is tear open a corner of this packet or cut it open and dump it into our plastic base. And we're going to zoom in so you can get a closer look at how that goes into our base. We've zoomed in and we're ready to pour our solution into our base. You can squeeze it to help it, and there's just the right amount to fill up our base. And if you look carefully, you can see something happening already. The cardboard's actually starting to wick up that liquid solution up through the tree. So what's happening here, or what's going to happen? Well, this liquid solution is going to continue to be drawn up all the way to the top of the tree through those branches. All of that liquid will be pulled into the tree, and eventually something's going to happen to that liquid. It's going to evaporate. We pulled in our tree that we made yesterday next to our new tree, and I want you to look and see what's missing. This tree, I have the liquid solution in my base. There is no liquid solution in the base of this tree. And that's the secret to why this tree actually grew. Where did the solution go? Well, it evaporated. In fact, if you look at this, we can actually see what's happening here. I spilled a little bit of the solution. There's a little wet spot right there. And then as I tried to wipe it up, there are these white streaks. Well, where did that come from? This is the same stuff that's making up our tree. You can see our tree at the bottom has, it's white just like this because there was no coloring there. But at the top of the tree, it's green. And in this case, it's going to be yellow. So what's the science behind our trees growing? Well, take a look at this. I have a glass of water. It's just plain, simple water. And I have some salt. Watch what happens when I pour some salt into our water and mix it up. In goes some salt. Now, I can see some salt at the bottom of my glass of water. Let's stir it and watch what happens. All of a sudden, there's no more salt on the bottom of my cup of water. Where did it go? Did it magically disappear? Well, no, it dissolved. That salt is still in the water. It's a physical change. Well, how can I prove that? I can taste it. It's definitely still in the water, but I can't see it. Now remember, there's salt dissolved in the water. I just can't see it. But what would happen if I let this sit for a few days? Well, all the water in the glass would evaporate. It would go into the air. We couldn't see it because it's a gas. A lot of people think all the water on our planet is in the oceans and rivers and lakes, But there's a lot of water in the air. We just can't see it because it's a gas. But something interesting would be left behind in the glass. The salt that we put into the water and dissolved would all of a sudden appear. It would be there. It would be left behind. See, that's the cool part about evaporation. When that liquid water turns to a gas and goes into the air, all of the dirt and all of the salt and all of the other stuff would be left behind. I could even put food coloring in this water, and that food coloring would actually color the salt left in our glass. That's the science that makes our trees grow. Just like salt is dissolved in this glass and I can't see it, there's something dissolved in this solution. The directions actually say it's potassium phosphate. Well, we can't see that potassium phosphate because it's dissolved in this liquid. But as that liquid is pulled up through that cardboard tree, the potassium phosphate is also pulled up through that cardboard tree. And as that liquid solution evaporates, the potassium phosphate is left behind, and that potassium phosphate mixes with the color, and now we have our beautiful tree growing. You can see our little cardboard branches peeking through the top. All of that potassium phosphate was left behind, and it crystallized. The crystals are solid. The solids were left behind after the liquid evaporated. Why is evaporation so important? Well, because all of the water that evaporates from our rivers and lakes and streams and puddles and oceans goes up into the air, and that becomes our rain and our sleet and our hail and our snow, but it's clean because all the dirt and all the salt is left behind in those rivers, lakes, streams, and oceans, and the clean water is up in the air that can fall later as rain. The people who designed this little toy call it the mystical tree. Well, I think it should be called the evaporation tree. We would like to thank our friends at Educational Innovations for sending us this cool little science toy. If you want to learn more about evaporation or weather or science, check out our YouTube channel, Fun Science Demos. Science is so cool, even when it almost happens right before our eyes. Thanks for watching.